octave of St. Patrick's Day is really and the Irish Bronx celebrate St. Patrick's Day all month, and some of us celebrate St. Patrick's Day all year. But I'm very pleased that your chairman is of Irish descent. He did mention Eli S. Carmen, who was really one of the finest men I've ever met. He was a great leader in this borough, a great leader in the business community and in the cultural community. He worked in the South Bronx, he worked in the North Bronx, he knew no neighborhood boundaries, the racial or civic boundaries. Elias was everywhere. And through Elias and Mike Thurso and Jim Morgan, I worked very closely with the Chamber in the early 80s when I was in charge of economic development. Hand in hand, the borough president's office and the Chamber worked very, very closely together. When I look at Michelle Dalgo over here as the granddaughter of Mike Thurso, I'm so pleased and so happy every time I see her because I see in Michelle Michael. I realize all the wonderful work that Michael did so many decades. So, Mike, please give our love to your family. Yesterday, Borough President Diaz celebrated Irish Heritage and Cultural Month at the Rambling House in Woodlawn. And when everything was over, I had been asked to MC the event. Lenny Carroll grabbed me, his only Lenny Carroll from Grammy, was like, Bob, I need you to help me tomorrow to mention some of the things that you mentioned at the event today about the Irish and the early years of the Irish coming to the United States. And I said that I would be willing to do that. He says, I've stopped the presses. We're rewriting the agenda. I said, Lenny, you don't need to rewrite anything. You don't need to cause extra work for people at the Chamber or my dear friend Vera Serratino at Bronx Design Group, who does all the printing for everybody across our entire county and does such an outstanding job. We can just do it off the cuff. So what I said to Lenny is I would mention some of the things that I talked about yesterday. The fact that the United States Congress, as well as the President of the United States, in the year 1991, established for the first time Irish Heritage and Cultural Month in the United States of America. But not to be outdone, you need to know that here in Bronx County, Borough President Fernando O. Ferrer, in 1988, declared Irish Heritage and Cultural Month and held the first Irish Heritage Festival in Bronx County. And that was followed by festivals with honoring all the other wonderful groups that make up our microcosm here in the Bronx. St. Patrick's Day is a religious holiday that honors the wonderful saint, St. Patrick, who introduced Christianity in the 5th century to Ireland. And today, of course, we celebrate that with luncheons like this and parades and all other wonderful festivities. The first St. Patrick's Day parade was held on March 17, 1762, in New York City, featuring Irish soldiers who served in the British military fighting for the colonies during the French and Indian War. And for those of us who remember the French and Indian War in our studies and never thought we'd have to remember or hear from it again, you just heard about the French and Indian War, which was a long time ago, but all of us will remember it was a regent's question, right? So you had to know about the French and Indian War. You couldn't just pass it by. So today we celebrate St. Patrick's Day, not here just in the Bronx, but in the United States and all across the world. Further research shows that of the 44 presidents of the United States, 22 of them have had Irish background, an Irish upbringing. All but one, of course, the one Roman Catholic president that we know is our own President John F. Kennedy. We remember every day of our lives as Irish Catholics. President Kennedy traced his family's ancestry back to County Wexford in the eastern part of Ireland. But during the administration of President Bill Clinton, more was done to fight on behalf of the Irish for reconciliation and peace in Northern Ireland. And it would be remiss of me or anybody else to let an Irish Heritage event go by and not mention the wonderful contributions of President Clinton and his administration, which resulted in the Good Friday Agreement in 1998. So let's hear it for President Clinton and all that really he did to bring peace to Northern Ireland. And there's one other great Irishman I want to remember today. He's 96 years young. He's over in the West Bronx relaxing and taking it easy after a very long and fruitful life. And that's that great congressman, that fighting congressman, Mario Biaggi. Because during the 1980s, we as Irishmen remember when a lot of other Irish took a nap down in Washington and weren't paying attention to the needs in Ireland, Mario Biaggi was calling and holding hearings. Mario Biaggi was going to Ireland. In fact, Mario sent my sister Carol and his daughter on a fact-finding mission, and Carol used to tell us about the bolts that were flying over her head. But that's the way Mario was. If he couldn't be there, he wanted some people he could trust to be there. So I want all of us to remember him, as we as the Irish have very long memories of who helped us and who was absent. And Mario Biaggi always helped us. So happy birthday, Mario, 96 years old this year. Bronx, there are several organizations that are working day in and day out. I am very proud to be county president of the Ancient Order of Hibernians. We've honored several fine Irishmen in this room and Irish women. And just this week, several of us went to St. Patrick's Home on Mashalu Parkway, and we gave out nice 14-ounce green shamrock mugs to every senior who was there, wishing them all well and wishing them a happy St. Patrick's Day. I'd like to thank my dear wife, Susan O'Nolan, from County Gravesend in Brooklyn, by way of Italy, for helping me pick out the nice mugs that went over so well. Thank you, Susan. I may run the County Hibernians, but Susan is my adjunct assistant and really has input into everything that we do, so I get the Italian flavor about how we do things. And I think that that's very important. Aside from the Hibernians, of course, all over the borough and all over the city, there's work that's done day in and day out by the Emerald Isle Immigration Center. There's a whole table of representatives of Emerald Isle here today. They do outstanding work. And once again, I want to mention that funding was given by Borough President Ofereo in the early 80s to the Emerald Isle. And because of that funding, we have an office that's open in Woodlawn today. And it still is open there, and it continues to be funded by Borough President Diaz. Finally, the Ashland Irish Center on McLean Avenue, they do outstanding work. And I just wanted to bring to your attention, for those of you who don't know, the outstanding organizations that fight day in and day out on behalf of the Irish and people who are not Irish in this county, because everybody out there serves the entire populace of the county. With that, I want to thank you very much. I want to thank the Chamber for this honor that they bestowed upon me and about my family today, my wife Susan, our son Christopher, who's able to join us today, and all my other friends who I see at all of these tables. Thank you so much for this very distinct honor.